Welcome to Power Electronics Lecture Series. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain online UPS. So before I explain online UPS, let us try to understand what is UPS. So UPS, that is Uninterrupted Power Supply, means when we have supply which is connected to critical load, at that time power could be easily delivered to the critical load, but in case of power failure, UPS will provide backup to critical load. So ultimately, uninterrupted power supply is being utilized in case of power failure is been happening. So here UPS, that is a device that is been utilized to provide continuous power to critical load even though there is a power failure. Now here, basically online UPS, this category I'll be explaining in this session. So let us try to understand what is online UPS. So in online UPS, circuit connection, that is almost similar to offline UPS, where here we have one phase or three phase power supply that has been given to rectifier circuit, and that rectifier circuit is giving DC output. So ultimately here at input of rectifier, AC input is there and output of rectifier, that is DC. Now this DC signal, that is been utilized to charge the battery. So here DC signal of output at rectifier will be utilized to charge the battery, as well as that could be given to inverter. So input of inverter is DC and inverter converts DC into AC. So output of inverter is AC. Then after that is AC static switch. So this is what AC static switch, that is there after inverter, and that is what connected to critical load. And one AC static switch that is connected from three phase mains. So ultimately AC signal that has been given to critical load. But when we talk about online UPS, the basic condition of online UPS is this static switch that is normally on and this static switch that is normally off. So let us try to understand how this circuit functions in three different modes. So first mode, that is when mains is on. So mode 1 working, where condition is when mains is on. So this is what mains means, input that is available. So at that time what happens inside? So when mains is on, at that time this three phase or one phase signal that is passing through rectifier, and that is what translated by AC to DC, and that signal is given to battery to charge the battery. So here charging is happening. So here charging is happening, and this main signal, that is what translated to DC from AC by rectifier, and that DC again will be given to inverter, and that will be resulted into AC. And in this mode, normally on switch is normally on. So here this signal will be delivered to the load due to this switch is on. So that is how this mode functions. So mode 1, that is what when mains is on. So at that time mains signal converted to DC by rectifier plus charger. So this is what the first thing that is happening. Then that DC signal charges the battery, and given to inverter. So this main signal that is charging the battery as well as it is given to inverter. And output of inverter given to load. Why output of inverter is given to load? The reason is switch, normally on switch is on. Normally on switch is on, that's why this signal will be delivered to the load. So this is how first mode is working. Again, in first mode where mains is on, one phase or three phase AC signal that will be translated into DC by rectifier, that same signal will be charging battery and that signal will be given to inverter to convert that DC into AC again. And normally on switch is on, so that signal will be delivered to the critical load. Now second mode of operation. So second mode is when mains is off. When mains is off means power supply is not available. So when power supply is not available, at that time battery will provide backup to the critical load. So in this case, this battery that is giving supply to the load via inverter. So this is what DC signal that is there with battery that is getting translated into AC by inverter, and this normally on switch is on. So ultimately now that will be delivered to the critical load. So when mains is off, battery provides backup. Then inverter converts DC into AC and output of inverter is given to critical load. How? It is normally on switch is on. So normally on switch, that is on, that's why this output of inverter will be delivered to the critical load. Now in third mode of operation, what if this UPS is getting failed? So in third operation what will happen? So in third operation case is, what if UPS is getting failed? So in case of this circuit, if this circuit which I have placed in box, if it is getting failed, so what will happen? So for that there is one condition here, and in that condition here three phase supply, that is what passing over here, and this normally off switch that is getting on, and this normally on switch that is getting off. So now this signal will pass through this switch and it will be delivered to the critical load, and during that time we can have a maintenance of this circuit. So during that time we can have a maintenance of this circuit. So what if UPS is getting failed? So when UPS is failed, at that time switches are getting triggered. So normally off is getting normally on, and normally on is getting normally off. So this signal now that will pass through this path and it will be delivered to the load. So normally on switch that is getting off, and normally off switch that is getting on. So mains is giving signal to critical load. In this situation, mains is giving signal to critical load. So this is how UPS is having three different modes. First mode is when mains is on, second mode is when mains is off, and third mode is when UPS is failed. Now I'll explain few specifications which we need to understand before we buy any UPS. So I'll explain what are the ratings which is there, which what are the specifications which is there with UPS. So power rating of UPS that is available by 1 kilowatt ampere, 2 kilowatt ampere and 5 kilowatt ampere. So this is the power rating, 1 kilowatt, 2 kilowatt, 5 kilowatt ampere that is available with UPS. Output voltage in India available with 230 voltage plus or minus 0.5%. Output frequency that is available by 50 hertz plus or minus 2 hertz. Input voltage range that varies from 190 volt to 260 volt. So if input varies in this vicinity, there is no problem. It will be providing steady voltage as we have seen at output voltage and output frequency. Power factor that is greater than 0.8 and it is been utilized as lagging, and that too because of inductive load. So lagging power factor that is been utilized due to inductive load, and it should be greater than 0.8. Backup time available with this online UPS from 30 minutes to 4 hours. So these sets of UPS available. Harmonic distortion, so that will be available with less than 5%. Efficiency of this set of UPS that is greater than 85%. And there are two different protection circuit which is required. One is over voltage and under cutoff protection. Over voltage under cutoff, and third is over current protection circuit is required for online UPS. So these three different circuits which is required to have a protection of online UPS: over voltage, under cutoff and over current protection. So these are the basic specification which is available, and this is how online UPS functions. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, then press like button, and if suggestions are required, give suggestions in comment. Definitely I will get back to you. Thank you so much for watching this video.